Kind attention paves the path to a meaningful life. First, it gives us courage to look at those parts of ourselves we don't want to see. And second, kindness showers us with dopamine, turning on our learning centers of the brain and giving us the resources that we need to change. True and lasting transformation requires kind attention. My teacher's words echoed in my ears, mindfulness isn't about attention, it's about kind attention. This attitude of kindness wasn't just a footnote or something nice to have. It was an essential part of practice, a part of mindfulness that's too often overlooked. So when I researched and developed a model of happiness and mindfulness, includes our attitude, intention, as well as our attention. All these three parts working together synergistically creates a meaningful change in people's life. Mindfulness is intentionally paying attention with kindness. So the intention is to cultivate this kind attention, even for seemingly unforgivable parts of ourselves. This may be one of the important things I've learned, that transformation is possible for all of us, and no matter what, it requires kind attention, not shame. And this kind attention takes practice, practice, and repeated practice. I want to share with you all a very simple practice that continues to help me till date. When I was going through a very tough time, I would wake up every morning with this pit of shame in my stomach. My meditation teacher suggested a practice of kind attention, and she said, Radha, how about getting up in the morning and saying, Radha, I love you. And I thought, okay, I can do it, but that sounds a bit too unnatural. She saw my hesitation and she suggested, how about saying, good morning, Radha, I love you, and try putting your hand on heart, because it releases oxytocin, you see. She knew the science would win me over. So the next day I put my hand on my heart and I said, I anchored my thoughts and I said, good morning, I love you, Radha. To be honest, I felt nothing except maybe a little ridiculous, but definitely not love. But I kept practicing, because as we know, what we practice grows stronger. And one day I felt it. I felt my grandmother's love. I felt my mother's love, my dad's love. I felt my own self love. I wish I could tell you that every day since then has been this bubble of self love, and I've never felt shame or judgment again. Ever since I have started this pathway of kind attention, it's growing stronger every day. So I wanted to invite you all to put your hand on your heart and say, hey, good morning, I love you. And if you are brave, you can do it twice, maybe one in the morning and one in the night. That's how you can make your life a bit more meaningful with kind attention practice. Attracting kind attention practice into your life. I shall see you in my next series of videos. Thank you for watching me.